story that he told to me. Changed my life. He said, we live in a world of brokenness. He said, it's obvious. People hate each other. There's wars, there's violence, there's addictions, there's immorality. It's all around us. We exist in this world of brokenness. It wasn't always that way. In the beginning, God created a perfect world. Roses didn't have thorns. There was no death. There was no disease. There was no hatred. There was no addiction. God placed mankind in this perfect world. And they had a relationship with God that was perfect. He gave them one rule. Don't eat of this tree of knowledge of good and evil. They rebelled against that one rule. And that's how mankind entered into brokenness. That rebellion is called sin. Now, my friend told me we try to get out of brokenness a variety of ways. I knew this was true. He says, people try to get out of brokenness with drugs. That was me. With alcohol. That was me. Immorality. Some people even try to get out of brokenness with religion. Others try to get out with making a lot of money. But none of those things actually get you out of brokenness. But my friend Rod shared with me, God loved mankind so much that he made a way out of brokenness. He said God loved mankind so much that he sent his son Jesus to earth. And that Jesus lived a perfect life. He raised people from the dead. He made blind people be able to see, deaf people be able to hear. And even though he didn't have to because he lived a perfect life, he died on the cross as a substitute in our place. And to show that he accepted that sacrifice, God raised him from the dead. 3 days. After he was raised from the dead, Jesus appeared to all his followers. And he told them to go everywhere, to every nation, and to tell people this story, and that if they would turn away from their sin and believe that he had came, died in their place, and risen again, that they could be restored into that perfect relationship with God, and that they could grow. Everybody that did that should obey his commandment to be baptized, and they should then, by God sends them to go back into brokenness and to tell that story. That's the story my friend shared with me, Terry. And he told me there's really only two places in the world. There's brokenness or God's perfect will. He asked me the same question I'll ask you. Where are you at? Then they get to choose. Where are you at? Here or here? What's the next question? Well, I'm there.
Where do you want to be?
Where do you want to be? Same question. I didn't get this. The first person I ever led to Jesus. Want to? Without ever being taught this. It's in us. out too.
He's completely different. I wanted what he had.
So,
watch this.
What if they say this?
I'm here.
Oh, you believe Jesus? What are you supposed to do with that person? Same thing that I just taught you guys to do. Make a list of five, tell their story in three parts, under 3 minutes, without religious language, okay? And teach them to do this. So guess what? You guys already know how to make a list of five people that are far from God, or up to 100. Now you know how to tell your story in under 3 minutes, no religious language, in three parts, and you can coach somebody else to do that. Now I've just modeled for you how to tell God's story using three circles and those two other cool ways. But this is one that you got to practice, okay? So,
hey, what's up?
So, what I want for you guys to do, I am killing it, man. We still got to get to the